أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم آية نمبر 61 It's a long ayah In this ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned regarding when Bani Israel You know Bani Israel now, right? The children of who? Huh? Yaqub alayhi salam, very good, mashallah. So now they are, in today's map, it's all Egypt. Because they cross the Red Sea, one wing. And they, from the main Egypt, they went to the Sahara of Sina. Okay? They're called Maidan of Tih, Yatihuna fil Ard. So now they are there. In the Sinai area, they are there. Egyptians, even today, they like to eat vegetables because it's agriculture. And adas, lentils. So they become used to Egyptian food when they were living in Egypt. Now they are here in the Sina and they are eating man and salwa. So they got fed up. And they asked Musa alayhi salam that give us some vegetables and ask your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that thing is mentioned. And how was their, the way they were asking question and how was their reaction, Allah mentioned it here. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, wa iz qultum. Wa mean? Ali? Wa? Wa mean and? And iz mean when? Qultum, you said. Ya Musa, O Musa, lan nasbira, we can never be patient, sabar, ala tu'amin, and food wahid in one type, fad'u lana rabbaka, so you do dua, you call for us your Lord, yukhrij lana, to grow out, Okay, to yukhrij lana, to bring out, kharij, mimma, minma, from what? Tumbitu grow al-ard, the earth. So look at the way it reflects, like the way they used to talk to Musa alayhi salam, there's a reflection of here. Like for example, look, they say, Ya Musa. They could have said, Ya Nabi Allah, Ya Rasul Allah, Ya Kaleem Allah, Ya Musa. Okay, lan nasbira, I can't be patient. But the respectful word on this occasion is lan nastatwi' as-sabr. We cannot afford to be patient, which means it is beyond our capability. But I mean, it was in their capability to be patient. So that is why they say lan nasbira. That's also very rude. And look at that. They don't say, our Lord, Rabbana. They would say, O Musa, call your Lord, Rabbaka. Okay, they could have said what? Rabbana, which is our Lord and you. So they don't own the Lord. Okay, your Lord. So, wa iz qultum, and when you say, Ya Musa, O Musa, lan nasbira. Okay, we can never. And the never meaning, as I told you, is coming from lan. Because they make it forceful. Ala tu'amin, and food wahidin. There was not one food, but one type of food. Because there was, as we say, at least two kind of food. Man and salwa. So, wahid mean one type. Fad'u ka lana for us, Rabbaka, your Lord. Yukhrij lana, to bring out. For lana for us, mimma is a combination of two words, min and ma. So, min mean from, and ma mean whatever. So, min, ma, from whatever. Tumbito. Okay, nabata yambutu mean growing. Is grown by al-ard, the earth. Min baqaliha wa qissaiha wa fumiha wa adasiha wa baswaliha. So ha, all these pronouns, zamair, they are toward the earth because earth is female. Okay, so you can say baqal mean spinach or vegetables in general. It's called baqal. And qissa mean cucumber. And foom mean wheat, or it can also mean garlic. And adas mean lentils. And basal mean onion. Okay, so look, we say adasiha mean her lintel. So her means like the lintels of the earth. So we say adasiha. Basaliha mean her onion. So her mean what? The literal meaning is that the onion of the earth. Okay? So min baqaliha, from its vegetables, spinach. Wa qissaiha, and its cucumber. Wa fumiha, and its wheat. Or it can also have the room of garlic. Wa adasiha, and its lintels. Wa basaliha, and onions. So you are learning Arabic. So Adil, these words are currently used also, right? They are like basal today is also onion. Adas is lintel today. Fum is used today for what? What is it? Garlic. For garlic mainly, right? But most of the tafasir they translated by wheat. And qissa also is used for cucumber today. No? What you call cucumber nowadays? Okay. And baqal, okay? So what Musa alayhi salam say? Qala atastabdiluna alladhi. Qala Musa alayhi salam say, atastabdiluna. Look like istif'al, istighfar. So I told you, remember, we are learning Arabic like a baby, little by little, okay? So keep on, but if depend on your shauk, your interest. Seen and ta, you bring with a verb, it will mean seeking, okay? Like istighfar, seeking forgiveness. Istinswar, istimdad, istiqbal, we use it, okay? Istiqbal means seeking the face. It means you are welcoming a person, istiqbal, right? So istibdal means exchanging. Seeking to change. Okay, istibdal. So are you, do you want to exchange alladhi, the one who adna, which is inferior? Okay, one is adna and one is a'la. Or adna and khair. So they are using, they come in opposition, okay? Huwa adna, which is inferior, billadhi, as compared to the one who khair, which is better. So you are exchanging, you are giving good thing and you are taking bad thing. Ihbitu misran. Ihbitu mean in zilu, go down. Misran in any city. So ihbitu, this call like for example, a person is coming from altitude to low land. So in the Arabic, it used like you are riding on a camel. So when you are your first foot, you are in the city, so you are coming down. So they said nuzul. Okay, that you, it never means that the city has to be low, and right now you are high, so we tell you go down. Okay, so it means like just enter. Ihbitu mean go down, which mean enter. Misran is common noun, it is nakira. So it doesn't mean this Egypt that is today. Misr in Arabic means city. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, enter in any city. And they were in the Maidan, they were in the Sahara, they were in the field, but there are small cities there, like as I told you, Ariha, which is like 5 miles from the Dead Sea, okay? And there are some other Satwim and some other cities, they were there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, enter in a city. فَإِنَّ لَكُمْ So indeed for you, مَا سَأَلْتُمْ what you سُؤَال, what you questioned. All these onions and garlic, they are waiting for you there. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't like their demand, so Allah say, وَضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ So dwaraba look like mean beating. But dwaraba, like for example, you put the concrete on the wall and you stick it to it, so it is used for that also, sticking. So here, وَضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ Stick to them, which means stamped upon them. الذِّلَّةُ ذِلَّة means disgrace. وَالْمَسْكَنَةُ and misery. Okay, so disgrace and misery was stamped upon them because of their attitude disrespecting the Prophet, the religion, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبَاءُ بِغَضَبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ Ba'u, the root word is bawa'un, which means abode, shelter. Like for example, you say ba'a bighadabin min Allah, they abode in a place where there was a curse of Allah. Okay, so it means that they earned, they deserve, okay, istihqaq. So this coming again in the Quran, okay, ba'a bighadabin wa ba'u bighadabin, which means they deserved. They turned to be deserved. Okay, and the root word is what? Abode, your destination, your shelter. So Waba'u, they took shelter in the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we translated that they deserved. They earned. بغضب anger من Allah from Allah. Okay, so look, zilla, disgrace, maskana, misery, and غضب mean anger. ذلك بأنهم, this is because they all were, كانوا they were يكفرون بآيات الله. Okay, so look, some people will understand, some will not understand. But if you don't understand, don't worry about it. So look, one fi'il is madhi, okay, and one is mudari. Mudari like yadribu, like ya'lamu, is mudari. Mudari means future. So when you bring kana and mudari, it gives the meaning of madhi istibrari, that something was done continuously in the past. Like for example, in the Quran, Allah says, wa kana ya'muru ahlahu bis salat. Ibrahim alayhi salam used to command his children for salat. So when you bring kana and mudhari, it become what? Madhi. And which madhi? Istimrari. Which mean, and this is used in the Quran. Kanu yaksibun, kanu ya'lamun, kanu yakfurun. Okay, so this is all they used to. This is what it gives me meaning. So they kanu yakfuruna bi ayatillahi. Yakfuruna is mudhari, and kana came, it gives the benefit of madhi istimrari, that they were continuously doing kufr, not like on one occasion. بآيات الله and the آيات of Allah. ويقتلون النبيين, and they killed the prophet بغير الحق unjustly. So look, we know that there was a prophet that the Arabic name is Yasiyah. Okay, and in English, in Bible we call it Isaiah. So they killed him. There was another prophet that Arabic name is Yirmiyah, and in a Bible called Jeremiah, they killed him. There's another prophet that the Quran called Zakariya, they killed him. There's another prophet whose name is Yahya, John the Baptist, they killed him. Okay, Isa alayhi salam, they tried to kill him, Iqdam of Qatal. And there are so many, this is only a few to mention. They killed the prophet, killing the prophet. Okay, so brave on Allah. Okay, they killing it like, you cannot even touch a prophet like. Bighair al-haq mean unjustly. So what that mean? That there could be a killing of a prophet with haq too? No. Bighair al-haq mean it, they also thought that it is not just. So bighair al-haq mean according to their thinking also it was not just to kill. Okay, so that's why bighair al-haq. Otherwise every killing will be unjust. ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا. This is because they disobeyed. وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. You see again, كَانَ كَمْ أَنْ مُذَارِ. And they used to do تَعَدِّي. تَعَدِّي mean crossing the limit. They used to disobey Allah and they used to cross the limit. So look, the ulama say from here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said they did two major things. Major thing. What? One is kufr and the other is killing the prophet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, what led them to do? Sin and crossing the limit. So the ulama say, small sins can lead to big sins. Because look here, isyan and crossing the limits are small sins. And they led, Allah say to what? Qatlul anbiya and kufr also. So that is why the ulama say, don't say this is small sin. Small sin is like small scorpion, small snake. Okay, and major one is like a big snake. So you say, okay, this is small snake, so that's fine, right? Okay, small sin is like a small fire. And big sin is like a big fire. So small fire is also dangerous. Okay, so small good deed will lead to big good deeds. And small sin will lead to big sins, according to this, okay? So look, this, if you look at this ayah, you might say, Quran is so hard on these Bani Israel that Allah say, I stamp upon them zilla and misery and anger. So then I was curious that what the Bible will say about it. So that let's compare, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, Quran is testify the subject matter of the Bible. So look at a couple, okay? One is a chapter in Bible which called Jeremiah. It is verse 2.30. It say, your sword has devoured your prophets like a destroying lion. Okay? Which means in simple English that your sword has eaten. Okay? Has cut. Love to cut. The prophets like a destroying lion. This is in Jeremiah. Okay. In Matthew chapter verse 23.31 to 36, look at it. That how, look at the resemblance of the Quran and the Bible today, okay, currently. It says, wherefore ye be witness unto yourselves, which means, this is old English, but it means, so you testify against yourself, that you should give a witness against yourself, that you did what? You are the children of those which killed the prophets, it say in the Bible. Okay, verse number 33 say, you serpents, and you generation of vipers, how can you escape the damnation of the hell? Okay, so it's very heavy. Look at the Quran. Quran is gentle. Serpents means snakes, and viper means scorpion. Like you who are the snake and the scorpion, how can you be avoid the destruction of the hellfire? Okay, look at verse number 34. It say, wherefore, behold, I send unto you prophets and wise men and scripture, and some of them you shall kill and crucify, and some of them shall you scourge, which means whip, in your synagogues, and persecute them from city to city. This is verse number 34. Verse number 35 say, that upon you may come all the righteous bloodshed upon the earth. Like whatever bloodshed is done until the day of judgment, it will come on your neck because you started it. From the blood of righteous Habil unto the blood of Zechariah, son of Barakiah, whom you slew between temple and altar, like between the temple and the pulpit, you killed. It's verse number 35. And then the verse number 36.16, the chapter of Chronicles, will say, but they mocked God's messengers, despised his words, and scoffed at his prophet until the wrath of the Lord was aroused against his people and there was no remedy. So you see, so I was just curious that what this is only the Quran is saying about ubi zillatin and maskana, or what their own book is saying, the Old Testament, which is also in the current Bible there. So let me repeat this ayah one more time quickly and then inshallah we are finished. Okay, wa iskultum, and when you say, ya Musa, oh Musa, lan nasbara, we can never be patient. Ala tu'amin wahidin, on one type of food. Fadu'u lana, call for us, your Lord. Yukhrij lana, to take out for us, mimma, from what? Tumbitul ardu, the earth growth. Min baqliha, from its vegetable. Wa qissaiha, and its cucumber. Wa fumiha, and its garlic and wheat. Wa adasiha, and its lentils. Wa baswaliha, and its onion. قال موسى say, أتستبدلون, are you exchanging الذي the one who أدنى which is inferior بالذي with the one who خير which is superior اهبتوا go down مصرا in a city فإن لكم indeed for you ما سألتم what you questioned وضربت and stamped عليهم upon them الذل disgrace والمسكنة and misery وباءوا أدي أن بغضب من الله the anger of Allah ذلك بأنهم this is because they were كانوا they used to يكفرون بآيات الله do كفر denial on the verses of Allah ويقتلون and they used to kill النبيين the prophet بغير الحق unjustly ذلك this is because بما عصوا they disobeyed وكانوا يعتدون and they crossed the limits right okay واخر دعوانا